I am the resurrection and the life.
He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believeth thou this? St. John 11:25-26. For I know that my Redeemer lives, that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worm destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another, though my limb be consumed with the moon. Lord, 19:25-27. And say, naked I come out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return hither. The Lord giveth, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Job 1:21. For we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can't carry nothing out. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Thank the Lord. Thank God for such occasion as this. I see it's a homecoming service. Thank you. God is a good God. Any good? Yeah, somebody say hi good like this. He's good all the time. Doesn't matter what the occasion may be, he's a good God. And we want to lift him up and give God the praise. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Thank God for this service, and we're going to have a high time. And at this time, we're going to turn this part of the service in the hands of Reverend Michael Smith. He's going to preside in my place. Let us lift up the name of the Lord. Tell the Lord, thank you. Tell him, thank you. Oh, thank you. He's worthy. Psalm said, I owe him a praise. And we're going to praise him today. Amen. Thank the Lord.
Good morning to everyone.
Morning. Morning.
God has called us all together for the celebration of life of Mother Doretha Waterman. The opening hymn we will have, O Lord, let me lean on you.
I got it.
In times like this, when all that we can do is call on the Lord.
Yes.
So as we turn our hearts and our minds unto Him, who is able to keep us from falling.
Yes.
And even to present us to a wise and omnipotent God. Mm-hmm. We call on the name of Jesus. For through him we are able to reach into the heavens. By him we are able to call on the one and only God that has given all these things unto us.
Yes.
So as we call on him now in a time of sorrow, we call on him because he has all power in his hand. We call on him because he was able to look on us even in a time of sorrow.
Yes.
And I pray unto him this day that, oh merciful God, that you will look down upon this family, Lord.
Yes.
Touch them, oh God, and give them peace of mind.
Yes.
Those that have had broken hearts and have seen the moisture run down their face from their eyes.
Yes.
We understand, oh God, that you are God that knows how to break all the bonds that hold us down and able to lift us up from out of the places that distress us and break our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, merciful God, look on this brown family now, Lord. Help them, oh merciful God, to understand that there is peace of mind in your word through the Christ that you have allowed to go to the cross.
Yes.
Help us now, oh God, to give this family comfort. Look on them, Lord, and help them to see that tomorrow the sun will shine.
Yes.
That early in the morning joy will come.
Yes.
Even though this day our hearts are heavy and our minds are fickle. But oh, merciful God, through your word, we ask you now, Lord, to bless this family.
Yes.
Hold them in your hand, oh God, and give them peace of mind.
Yes.
Look upon the children and sisters and brothers and all of those that's connected, Lord. Help them to understand that all is not lost.
Yes.
That even though we give up the ghost of this body, we lay down this flesh down in the buried ground. But one of these old days, God, when the trumpet sounds, somebody will call their names. And when they hear their name called, we understand, oh God, in that day of that great getting up morning, that someone would hear the name called and the dust would begin to shake in the earth and the ground would give up
that
was planted. We would see the beauty of another day in the glory of the Lord. Oh God, we thank you for our sister life. We thank you, oh God, for the time that we knew her. We thank you, oh God, for giving her this longevity, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all that was done. For now, Lord, we know that a day will come when we must answer the call. Oh, merciful God, touch these that are here, that they may understand that this thing will not pass us by. That soon and very soon we will have to give up our own ghost.
Oh, yes.
And we will have to lay down the soul flesh.
Yes.
And we will have to stay down until someone call our name.
Yes.
Help us now, God. Prepare us to receive a word that it will prick the hearts of those that are still yet alive.
Yes.
Oh, merciful God, be with this family.
Yes.
Be with your messenger, oh God.
Yes.
Bless her, oh God.
Bless her.
Fill her with your spirit.
Yes.
That we would be fed and that we would know that there is a God. And though we rest, yet shall we get up on that great getting up morning to receive the blessing that was announced for all of us.
Yes.
Through Christ Jesus, I pray. And all God's children say, amen,
amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Old Testament scripture, first division of Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Rod and thy staff to comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Amen.
God's words in the Old Testament, New Testament. Gotta use the technology. Thank God. St. John chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way ye know. But Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? But Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Against God's words to God's people. Amen.
There's a green Toyota, a gray Toyota, with the blinkers on, right in front of the door. You need to go and turn the blinkers off. Amen.
Amen.
Toyota Camry.
Yeah.
We would like to thank Reverend Singletary for that soul-stirring prayer, and Reverend Cummy for the scripture. Here on the program, it has a reflection limited to 2 minutes. I know it's hard to just do 2 minutes, but try your best. Amen? And then we will have MacArthur Brown, the brother, Shalinda Lassane, granddaughter, and Patrick Burgess, nephew. And then we'll come back before they acknowledge you. Amen?
Amen.
Go in that order. MacArthur Brown.
Christ, who's first in my life, who I need for everything.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
And he needs me for nothing, but I thank him. I'm here today to say a few words about my sister. I'd like to say 2 minutes, a short time, but I'll just tell you some of the start up kids in my life from my sister. When I was young, having a big sister, She played a role as a mother too.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you can come from a big family and you got siblings way at the top and you way at the bottom.
Yeah.
Older sister is mama too.
Oh, yeah.
She didn't just take care of you. She put that thing on your butt too. But anyway, you know, as time went on, grew up, be a young man, I would often go spend time with my sister. She would come and take me home and tell me I could stay as long as I'd be good. And when I was bad, she'd bring me home. And when she'd come to see me again at mom and daddy's house, I would be sitting there popping. And she would say, stay good. You mad with me? I pout. She said, you want to go with him, homie? I jump across the table, slide down the hall. She said, get you something to put on. I grab all kind of clothes. She said, you don't need but just something for the night. I said, okay. But anyway, as a child, having a big sister like her, I'm blessed.
Yes, yes.
And I want to speak on love, because she had a lot of that. She had a lot of love for all her family members, her friends. And if she can do anything for you, she would. And that's what we all need, a lot of love. And that's what the world is full of, love. We got so much love, but the secret to that is so many people stingy with it. They won't give it like it's supposed to. They want to keep it for themselves. Everybody got a lot of love, they choose something else. So when you got love, you express love, it shows on you. And if you got something else, it wears on you. You hear me? You don't wear a smile. You don't seem happy. There's always something wrong. I don't know what it is, but it ain't love. But when you got love, you don't need nothing else. And I was blessed with that. And my sister, she was a strong lady, you know. She been through a lot, she seen a lot, and she tolerated a lot. And she was kind of like, she was kind of like a bag of tea. You know what a bag of tea is? You put it in hot water, and you don't know how strong she is until you put it in hot water. So that's the kind of sister she was. So I just want to let the family know, you know, we suffering a loss, and we the only ones suffering because she's going to heaven. And we just gotta learn to let go and do what she would want us to do, and that's carry on. And we gotta carry on as a family. And for the last couple of years, it seemed like this train just won't leave our neighborhood. It just stayed right there, but we still gotta carry on. And we can do the best we can with that. So that's what I want to say about love. And we having a home going from a sister. And we don't want to feel so down. And we all know the word hate. You know? And I got a version for that too. And my version, a short version of hate, is anybody, or any team that beat up on my Dallas Cowboys.
So Grandma is a vibrant soul whose love touches and encompasses everyone with protection. Is emphasized because although her body is not here, her soul is in her body anymore, her soul is still with us. And I know that it's hard to accept death because death is always harder than the living. But when you feel pain, remembering the memories, thinking about how she's a part of your everyday life, how you incorporate her in almost everything that you do, that pain is a reminder that she was a beacon light and that she served her purpose. And although you can't physically come and speak to her, you can still speak to her spiritually because her soul is still here and her soul will still protect and cover you. And I know it hurts, but that pain just lets you know how much she touched you and how much she means to your soul itself. Thank you.
Yes. They tell us
We're supposed to limit 2 minutes. So if I go over a minute, y'all please forgive me. Because this is my last time, and I'm not getting to tell my aunt goodbye. So, you know, my uncle and my cousin, they pretty much sum it up about my aunt. But they left out one thing. One thing that me and her shared. And me little coming up, my aunt could always cook some good collard greens. I ain't gonna lie to her. She cooked some good collard greens. And I mean, everybody know my aunt as Doretha, but we from the country. I'm country. I always know her as Aunt Risa. And that's what I was always taught, that's your Aunt Risa. And that's the way that I'm gonna remember her, as Aunt Risa. You know, she would put that collard greens on Sunday, and Linda and Marvin, they'd be outside. I'm younger than them, but I'm waiting on that collard greens. You know, y'all know what I'm talking about, with that collard greens, with that fat back beginning and everything. Man, that's a good collard greens. And you know, the last time I talked to my aunt, I was on the way going to work. I left my mama's house, and I called my cousin. I said, send me Aunt Risa's number. And she sent me the number, and I called Aunt Risa. And she talked to me all the way from work to the plant site. I said, Aunt Risa, I said, I got to go into work. But I want to let you know that I love you, and you're my favorite aunt. And the last time I said, Aunt Risa, I got one question I need to ask you. She said, what you want to ask me? I said, when you going to cook some of that collard greens? She said, boy, get out my face and go on to work. So, you know, when I see everybody in this church right here, you know, representing my family, that makes me feel good. But the one thing I want to tell everybody, and I really want you to hear me when I say this, if you got a mother, if you got a father that's still living, don't wait till the last minute to let them know that you love them. You know what I'm saying? You know, because God ain't playing. God is not playing. You know, my aunt, she's home. She's home. She's where we want to be. You know, so you know, I'm telling all my uncles, my aunts, my cousins, my friends, everybody who's here, thank you. Thank you. And I also want to tell my cousin Linda and my cousin Marvin, I thank y'all for letting me have this moment with my aunt. And I love y'all with all my heart. And I want y'all to remember, y'all lived through y'all mama. And recently she done paved the way for y'all. Now it's time for y'all to carry on the memory. So every time you get up in the morning time and you start thinking about mama, look in the mirror. She's right there. Amen. Looking dead at y'all. And you know she ain't playing. She ain't playing at all. But one way or the other, I'm gonna get them collard greens though.
Thank everyone for all the reflections. But I would like to just say, not only that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal, it says in the Bible that we should mourn when a baby is born. Because you don't know what that baby's gonna go through. But when one died in Christ, we all celebrate. Because of the great things God has done through his son, Jesus.
Yes, yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Sister Linda, Bobby, family, you don't have no reason to hold your head down because you took care of your mother. That's love. What a brother talked about, that's love. Most people will throw their loved ones in the nursing home and forget about it. But to be there. You know, when you take care of your mother, your father like that, you know, God will prepare somebody to take care of you. When you get old, it's all a blessing. So we thank God for you. Hold your head up because God got your back. I like to tell people when you're on God's side, it's like I'm not trying to preach tonight. The preacher's getting ready to come. But I just love the word of God. And I want you to know when you're on God's side and you make God your personal savior. He got your back just like there was this little baby bear. And a mountain lion was trying to get that little baby bear. And that little bear stand up on both of his back legs. And Lord let out a roar. And when he did that, the mountain lion ran away. What the baby bear didn't see, there was a great big bear behind him that had his back. That's the way God got us. He got our back. He watched over us. Even when death comes, God got our back. We go from life, death, right into life. Because Jesus was the firstborn from the resurrection. He made a way for all of us. And all of us got to travel this way. So the preacher is getting ready to come. I just wanted to share that. Because when you're in Christ Jesus, it's just hard to hold on. To hold on to your the goodness of the Lord. Amen. Next we will have the acknowledgement by Rebecca Woodbury. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. It will be by Megan Brown. Right, okay. Rebecca Woodbury will come and do the acknowledgement. That's the sister-in-law. And then we will have Megan Brown will do the solo. And Pastor will come, Pastor Elder Carletta P. Johnson will come and bring the word from God. And I thank you for allowing me to serve today. Amen.
Special people in our lives are never really gone. This is to Ms. Linda from Lucy, Raven, and Shania. As soon as people journey through life, they leave footprints of kindness and love, courage and compassion, joy and faith. Even when they are gone, the trail they have left behind continues to inspire you. This is from Mabel, Graham, and family. You are in my prayers. It's so hard to lose someone you love. no words can't take away the sadness you feel. This is from Larry and Martha. Thinking of you and love of your mother, there is love that will live forever, and there are memories that will shine through the sorrow. With deepest sympathy from Reverend Michael Smith and Evangelist Claudel Smith. In sympathy and friendship with caring thoughts from John and Catherine and Jacob Brown, we love you all. In appreciation, the family of the late Doretha B. Waterman wishes to express their sincere appreciation for many acts of kindness shown during the passing of their loved ones. Your prayers, visits, telephone calls, and all other expressions of sympathy have been a great comfort during our bereavement and will be greatly remembered. May God bless you in a special way. Amen. I want to see
to live with the Lord. Amen. God is good.
Yes, he is.
Do you want to be with him?
Amen.
Soon be over. It's going to be soon be over. We having trouble, but it's going to soon be over. With the trouble of this world. We are going through so much trouble. But it's going to soon be over. Thank you. It's going to soon be over. Let's tell the Lord thank you. Let's tell him thank you. Let's wake up. God is too good. The psalmist said, I've come a long journey. Long journey. But Jesus was right there. Right there. By our side. He never leaves us nor forsake us. He's a good God. And I tell you, I like to have a good time. I like to have a good time. We feel like we're sleeping in here. We need to wake up. Tell God, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. He's good all the time and all the time he's good. Even on that this occasion, he's still a good God. And he wants us to give him praise and glory. Because we're supposed to have a homecoming.
Yeah.
It's a homecoming. A celebration of her memory.
Yes.
We thank God for this sister Dorita B. Water. Let's pray, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Lord, come on in. Lord, bless. In a mighty name. They call it a decrease. Let you increase. Have your way, Lord.
Yes.
Oh God, we tell you thank you.
Yeah.
We give your name the praise and glory. Father, Son, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, I met Miss Dorita. She was so humble. You didn't say too much, but she was a humble spirit.
Amen.
And you the people with a humble spirit, you can tell the difference.
Amen.
You can know them. And how they feel, you can feel love. Thank the Lord. We thank God for all the remarks that was said about Miss Dorita. And I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to eat none of those collard greens. But she cooked the best collard greens, and I didn't get a chance. So we just thank God. We know that sometime when the people are not here anymore, that God has passed that gift down to the children. Isn't that something?
Amen.
He passed it down to the children. All the grandchildren. Somebody get that gift.
Yes.
Isn't that something? Yes.
Yeah,
somebody be able to cook like grandma.
Yes.
Our mom. Yes, sir. Our sister. Thank the Lord. God passes that gift around.
Amen.
But we thank God for the life that she lived.
Amen.
The life that she shared with you.
Amen.
The children, the grandchildren.
Amen.
Even the great-grand. We thank God for the sisters and the brothers. And how she prepared herself for this moment.
Amen.
And today we got to get ready.
Yes.
Yes, sir. We got to get ready.
Yes.
Because time is growing near.
Yeah.
And it's not far away anymore, but it's growing near.
Yes.
And today we're going to draw your attention to Matthew 24 and 44 saying, therefore, be ye also ready. For in such an hour,
yes,
as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh.
Yes.
Subject, be also ready.
Yes.
Thank the Lord. When you look at that, they say be. Look at it as another letter in the alphabet. But it represents to prepare ourselves, be in a state of a condition. The quality of a degree of effort.
Yeah.
But today we're talking about the condition, the state of condition.
Yeah.
To be ready.
Yeah.
Also likewise. Ready meaning to prepare.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus, to prepare.
Yeah.
Anytime you get ready to take a trip, you gotta prepare yourself.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You can start packing, but the first thing you got to do is get your ticket.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Get a ticket.
Yes.
Because you can't take a trip without a ticket.
All right.
Hey?
All right.
Yes, sir. And then we need a ticket. Whatever journey you're going to travel, whether on the plane, the bus,
yes,
the train,
keep it packing up.
Yeah.
And that's what we got to do. We standing around, we young, we old, we middle aged, we senior citizens. But we got to pack up.
Yes.
Jesus want us to do what we need to use. But we don't think about it. We feel like, I got to live. I ain't got time. I got to have a good time.
Right.
Sometimes people say, child, you ain't living yet.
Uh-huh.
But who know?
Yes,
in this very time, small grave, medium-sized grave, big grave,
yes,
even much a little grave,
yes,
we are leaving here.
Yes.
We need to pack up.
Yes.
Get ready. Be also ready.
Yes.
Because there is when there was 10 virgins in the 25th chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody thought they were ready.
Yes, Lord.
But five of them was wise.
Yes.
And five was foolish.
Yes.
Foolish.
Yes.
The wise virgin take off in their land and had this all. But the foolish virgin took the lamb and didn't take no oil. Because that's a sad thing. Because we all together having a good time, digging on the choir, shouting and preaching and doing some of everything. But when the bridegroom came, when he came, it was too late. Isn't that something? Sometimes we think we're ready, we're not ready. That's right. Everybody going together, having a good time. I mean, having a good time. They're on the choir, and you know, everybody shouts, speaking in town, and singing and everything. I always say the devil can do everything but live right. Your life lives. I told somebody this morning, don't let your sermon, if that's the hear sermon, did see a sermon, didn't hear a sermon. She didn't understand what I said. What you mean to see a sermon, then hear the sermon? Your life, the life you live, it speaks louder than what you say. When you look at this woman and hear how she was and the children being around her, you can't fool people. Because the life you live, you can talk all you want. You can talk all you want, but your light shines. Let Jesus be in your life. Let the light in you be Jesus. I may not hawk and carry on today. I can't say anything to bring Ms. Doretha back. She preached her life when she was living.
Amen.
But we that are here,
yes,
we better get back.
Yes.
Jesus is coming.
Yes.
He's coming, the Bible said, as a thief.
All right.
In the night.
Yes.
And we know that the thief was coming. We would put all our bad things up. But you don't know. And that's how Jesus comes. When you think not,
right,
when you're taking it easy, hallelujah, when you're taking it easy and say everything is fine, here comes Jesus. We got to get ready to go back with him.
Amen.
Lord, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
We don't know when he's going to appear,
right,
but yet we know he's coming.
Yes.
I said, get your ticket.
Yes.
Your ticket is free. Jesus paid the price.
Yes.
On Calvary.
Yes.
Yeah. indeed I baptize with water, the 11th verse, unto repentance. But he let us know one is coming after me, which you are not worthy to unloose. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. There's a conjunction. Hallelujah. Sometimes we get saved. We get sanctified. Sometimes after a while we turn around. Hallelujah. But you can come back around. Hallelujah. Stay at the altar. Call upon the name of the Lord. For the Holy Ghost and that fire baptism can burn up sin. Hallelujah. Come and be brought into sin. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You can go back to the Father.
Amen. Be their burning bear, the heart fix, and a mind recollect.
Yes.
God bless every that are here today, Lord. Yes. Even those that take a part in this service.
Yes.
Oh, God, have your way. Let them know that you are there for them. Everything they need, you got, God.
Yes.
Oh, God, have your way. Have to seek you, Lord. And prepare themselves to meet you, God, one day. And oh, Father, we tell you, thank you.
Yes.
We give you the praise and glory.
Yes.
In the holy name I pray. Father, Son, Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Let's look to the Lord. Thank you.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father. Glory be to the Son. Glory be to the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Let us all say,
Amen.
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 Amen. Friends, the staff come and from that service here, we journey to the Wilson Cemetery to find resting place for one of the family who are part of the year. Allow me to express their thanks to you, first of all, to Pastor Zion Glass and also Kevin Johnson for coming here and providing services for us, to all the other ministers who came. May God continue strengthening them in their ministry. To the many friends and family who came to see love, this family, may God bless them and strengthen you. As we go through the difficult and trying time that we know not what tomorrow holds, we know who holds tomorrow. Continue to give our strong faith. That's what scares all of us. It's the family again. And I pray to serve you with our team strength and bless you. So this, we're going to have our Father meeting here at the altar. We're going to get some of the DVD and exit on it. Okay, minister, y'all will receive just a second. Again, on behalf of the family, thank you so much for coming and joining the homeward celebration. God bless it back to you. Thank you so very much.
Even here.